I escaped from the family farm, had a tenancy, and it was actually when I got the chance to buy my farm off the landlord. My family had a mixed farm. I moved off to a tenanted farm initially and was very intensive farming. I was struggling to rear a young family and pay a mortgage on the farm. We've got beef cows, we've got a flock of sheep, and it really is a case of as little time as possible on the farm, because that's where, sadly, where we don't earn the money. I'm Alex Gingell. My son is Harry, and we trade as Copford Farm and Sawmill. We're in the village of, or on the outskirts of the village of Waldron, near Heathfield, in East Sussex. We're still farming here. I've got two lads, one of them's involved with the farm, and Harry's joined me, and he's now running the sawmill. We're just turning out timber as fast as we can. So if we can get the timber out quicker than the other sawmills, they'll usually go with our product.
When I first come to the business, Dad's been running it with one sawmill, and yet within 2 years, we're now on it. We've got two sawmills we're running, and one day we could uprate the other sawmill, but it's only because around us there's a need for the timber and a need for someone to mill out the timber. People like the fact that they know where the timber's come from. It's quite romantic that the timber that they're getting has come from a forest near them. They can almost go and walk around where their extension has come from, basically. And people like that idea.
I was roughly 40 when I bought my first Wood-Mizer, and I was so keen to have something that earned me good money, whereas farming wasn't at that point. I was buying a little bit of timber and cutting up on the farm. More and more people were wanting timber off the farm. The roads were getting busier. I'd had enough trailing a train around the counties doing timber and then coming back and farming morning and evening. I was on my own then. So it just slowly evolved, and then eventually I got to the point where I completely gave up the mobile milling and became a static mill. And orders just keep coming in. I was always frustrated that you used a machine 1 month of the year, put it away for 11 months, got it out, and had to try and lubricate everything up again and get it working. When you're working a sawmill 12 months of the year, you tend to keep on top of maintenance, and it's a nice feeling to know that you're on top of your machine all the time. We have to keep spares. We know we've got suppliers not far away when we need backup. We are lucky that we're in an area of Great Britain that for hundreds of years has been using oak as a building material. If you look at some of the local villages, the houses are built out of very heavy beams, and this is partly what people are trying to replicate with new builds, new garages, or even repairs to the old ones. Every hardwood tree we pull out is destined for a specific beam. It's not just a case of pulling it out, running it out, and hoping for the best.
We're quite specialist, so we're always cutting to order rather than putting stuff in stock for waiting. What we're supplying is the timber for extensions, for garages, and like I say, because people don't want to sell their house, they want to do them up. And oak's a nice product, and people like the idea of oak, so they want an oak extension or an oak gazebo for their garden because they're not moving now. It's nice to see the finished product as well. We get a lot of customers who send us photos of what they've built. We've got a small website, it's very basic, just a couple of photos, contact numbers, etc. It is very basic, but it just shows who we are, what we do.
I can't see us doing more machining as such. I think the demand is there just for sawn timber. But having said that, who knows what's around the corner? I started life as a farmer, I'm now a sawmiller. If I hadn't changed my mind, I'd still be farming, and I'd still be broke.